what we have here is a queen cage. Whoop! Hello. Shoot. Bam. There she is. Let's go put it right there. So that's a queen, a mated queen in a cage. And I'm introducing her to this colony, which is queenless. It's a colony that actually, it's a swarm that I caught. And I brought it to my house. And I set them up, and they were really mean bees. And I couldn't figure out why, so I left them alone for a week. And they should have had some brood by then. And when I checked on them, there was no brood. And there was no queen, no virgin, nothing. There's no signs of a bee, of a queen being in this colony. So I said, well, I guess they're queenless. Something happened there. I don't know exactly what happened. There's all kinds of things that could happen. Maybe someone knows. I've never caught a swarm that didn't have a queen before, but I know you can get after swarms that have virgin queens and that sort of thing. I don't think that's what's happening here. This was a huge colony, or what I would consider a huge colony, a huge swarm. Anyway, they were queenless, so I got a mated queen, and I put her in yesterday. I've got her in this cage just to see if they're ready to accept the queen, and you can see, well, I can see it. You probably can't see it on the camera, but they're trying, the queen is in there, and they're just crowding that cage, and they're trying to, you can see them, I can see them. Again, it's just me, but you can see they're poking their little tongues into the queen. They're licking that queen. They're feeding that queen. They want a queen very desperately. And so they're just getting to know the queen. And you can see the one up top right here. It's I can see its tongue sticking into that hole, and the queen is, they just want to feed the queen. And the queen will accept food from them, and they'll exchange fluids with the queen. They'll exchange basically her pheromones, and they'll spread those pheromones all throughout the hive. It's just like swapping spit. And then everyone gets a taste of the queen, and they all get relaxed because they know they've got a nice queen. She's laying eggs. She's doing everything a queen needs to do. And that's what it looks like they're doing. It looks like they're ready to accept her. So, and meanwhile, she's and I checked her from, this was just yesterday I put her in, I think. Yeah, it was yesterday. And she's they haven't killed her, and they're not trying to kill her, and she's alive and well, and she's being fed. And when you pull you try to pull them off the cage, so they're not mean, they're not agitated, they're totally chilled. They're like, I've got a glove on now, but I don't even need a glove. They're just so relaxed and so happy to have a queen. And when they don't want a queen, if this is a foreign queen who doesn't smell like them, oh, they're all slowly catching on that she's here. I can see it in the camera, but they're all walking towards the queen. If this was a foreign queen that they didn't want, and see, I think I might even have queen pheromone on my finger, and they're just sort of hanging out wherever the queen pheromone is. If they didn't want this queen, they would be trying to sting her. And you'd see them with their bodies bent and trying to get into her with their butts poking into the cage, and not their mouths and their tongues. So they seem happy to have a queen. So I'm going to keep her in that cage, though, for at least another 2 or 3 days, just to make sure that they're ready, they're totally ready and chilled out and cooled off and ready to accept a new queen. And even before that, I will check some of the frames where brood would be laid, just to make sure that there isn't a virgin queen in there or something crazy going on. You never know. Like, when it comes to queens and swarming and requeening, it's just a lot of weird things can happen. So I'm just going to be ultra safe and ultra careful. And I'm going to just check the hive one more time before I release her. And I'm releasing her manually instead of with, because sometimes they go right here, they'll put a candy. They're not entirely happy about that. Hold on. Yeah, sometimes we put a candy plug at the end of the cage, and the bees will eat out the candy, and they'll release the queen. But sometimes they even though they do that, they're still not ready for a queen, and they'll reject the queen and they'll supersede her. So I'm playing it safe, and I'm just going to let them hold on to that queen for at least 5 days, and I will personally make sure that she's okay, and then I'll let her go. I won't let them let her go too early. And there we go. I'm going to put her back in between two frames. they don't, well, it's funny, they're coming after me, but they're not trying to sting me. They're just saying, hey, human, leave my queen alone, I guess. So that's what I'm gonna do. So she's right there, smack in the center. I'll show you where she is. She's right down there. And so I'm gonna leave them alone at least for another 3 days, and then we'll see how it goes.